Hello, I'm John McGrath. I'm a producer for Flatland at Kansas City PBS. And today on Art House, we bring you the film Nelly Don, the musical. Art House sat down with its writer-director, Terence O'Malley, and we discussed not only the difficulties of making a musical, but also one that's a period piece.
What do you think?
Nelly Don. That's Donnelly inverted. Very creative.
I'm glad you like it.
It's a little bit of you and a little bit of me.
Well, Nelly Don presents the story in a musical narrative about the world's largest dress manufacturer during the 20th century.
Think what you could do with them. From these ugly duckling frocks, you can create a graceful swan.
A young woman who hailed from Parsons, Kansas. It's got a lot of elements to it, and it's got a lot to the story because her life was so amazing. And really, we only take her up to about age 44, and she lived to be 102. Everybody on the crew was from Kansas City. From the choreographer to the director of photography to the makeup people to the costumers and to, you know, the lighting people, the electricians, the sound people, all of them were from Kansas City. We ended up employing about 105 people on the film.
I have decided not to let housework make a frump out of me. I abhor the cheap, shapeless bags we're expected to wear. It offends my sensibilities.
I think Julie was the number three person to audition. And after she auditioned, I turned to one of my people and I said, well, at least we have one Nell. You know, I was like, okay, we got one person who could play Nell. Well, there was nobody else the rest of the time that could play Nell. I mean, she just became it. I just knew this gal is Nell.
If you ever cared for me at all, just do this one thing for me.
Virgil let him down, round and round.
You know, obviously it's one thing to shoot a movie, but it's another to shoot a movie that is a musical. And so you don't just go on set and start singing. That doesn't work. So there was a lot of pre-production that went into these musical numbers, not the least of which was that we rehearsed at Avila University for a week. And we got all the actors and actresses familiar with the music. We got the musicians familiar with the music. Then we went into the studio and recorded it for a week. So it took us 2 weeks to really lay down the musical tracks.
And for the right price, we even pay twice for a Nell Donnelly.
We would usually shoot a song, you know, two or three times in one camera position, you know, depending on movement, and then switch camera positions and, you know, cut the song again and again and again and again.
So, now, you know you gotta sell!
We shot for 29 days of principal photography, and that was another challenge to this because most movies get made, say, in a, you know, field production and principal photography. They get made in about a, you know, somewhere between a 30 and 45 or 50 day period. So everybody comes together and, you know, collectively are just focused on this, you know, movie that they're producing. We started principal photography in May, and we ended it in November of 2022.
Please don't hurt me!
Well, not only is the film complicated by the fact that it's a musical, but it's also a period piece. I mean, you know, it goes from 1897 until about 1934. And so, you know, we had to figure out, okay, how do we shoot it in such a way? Obviously, costumes and hairstyles were one way to do it. But then, you know, when you go to some modern place, well, you can't have a modern light switch, you know, and you can't have, you know, smoke detectors and, you know, other, you know, things like that. So I think that people were comfortable in knowing, okay, we understand we're in this era now.
She moved to Kansas City.
You know, the takeaway really from the film, besides the entertainment aspect of it, is for people to be blown away by what this woman accomplished. She started off hand sewing dresses in 1916, and by 1931, they were making 5,000 dresses a day right here in Kansas City.
We got 24 hours to get this dressmaking dame back.
And we may be going down the same path, the path of least resistance.
You're in big trouble, lady.
We want people, especially young women, to know that the possibilities are unlimited if they follow their dreams and they follow their hearts and they work toward what they want to accomplish, and to not let people take away their dreams from them.